Slap. Doopie didn't even know slut was a word, much less what it meant. You can only imagine how that went. Doopie only said slut because it rhymed with debt. Number 3 was submitted by P.I.G. Doopie was at the mall with his mom and three of her brothers. That day, he was going to Mango. A group of cute girls were walking towards him, and Elvin's youngest brother decided to do passing in the middle of the mall. Elvin was so embarrassed his face instantly turned red. He pulled up his pants, then ran to the nearest restroom and pitched his brother until he cried. That was the last time he ever went to Mango. Number 2 was submitted by DeathNick35. Mason was his father when he was about 2 years old. He was at the beach with his mom and grandma, and right as he came out of the water, a lady next to him went in. When Mason came out of the water, he really had to pee, and the lady next to him left her picnic basket open. He thought it was a toilet and peed in it. He covered all the sandwiches, and when she came back, she wouldn't wear sandwiches with sloppy and smell bad. Mason's family didn't see him do it.
Number 1 was made by Pinkie himself.
I can't believe it. I was in the 4th grade, and the class had to go to the library. During this time, I had some really good dreams the day before. When the class was all gathered up in the library, the dreams started coming back in a way, and my stomach was really rumbling. I didn't know if this was either gas or just poo-poo. So when I let out what I thought was possibly poo-poo, it was a really strong fart. Around me, all the kids said,
"Ew, smell my crackers, ew!"
After that, it was difficult for me to cope with my emotions and embarrassment, and I kind of faded into obscurity. To this day, I still have trouble holding in my gas. Huge thanks for the folks over at Brother Dawn subreddit for submitting their stories. I have another question for you. What was the strangest thing you ever saw happen in your school? Let us know in the red page link below, and you might be featured in a future chapter.
Owen used his phone and headphones. First, he read over all the answers and recorded them on his phone. Next, as in the day of the test, he plugged his earbuds in and put them up in the arm he didn't write with. From there, Dylan put the earbud in